Hello everyone, initially we have one circle, and point O is given as center point. Point A and point C, these are given as tangent point. And radius of the circle is given 4 units, this length is given 5. So the question is, what is the length of the x? Okay. First step. If you draw a perpendicular line onto the chord like this, and let's call here alpha, here theta, we know that alpha plus theta equal 90 degrees, right? And point A is given as tangent point, that means angle DAB must be equal alpha. Therefore, angle ABD is equal theta, right? Let's call here point K. If you focus on this triangle and this triangle have same angles, that means these two triangles are similar. So triangle KOA and triangle DAB are similar. After that, if we draw one more perpendicular line from the center onto the tangent line, like this, this length is also radius, right? So here is 4 units. If you focus on here, we get a rectangle, right? So OKDC is a rectangle. If here is 4 units, that means this length is also 4, right? So x minus 4 left here. After that, I want to represent this length with y. So 5 minus y left here. Y, according to two tangent theorem, these two lengths must be equal. Therefore, if it is 5 minus y, that means this length is also 5 minus y. Then, if we start our calculation from this triangle, x minus 4, which is opposite of the alpha, over y, which is opposite of the alpha, must be equal 4, which is opposite of the 90 degrees, over 5, which is opposite of the 90 degrees, equal 5 minus y, which is opposite of the theta, over x, which is opposite of the theta. After that, if we use left-hand side of the equation, we get 5x minus 20 equal 4y. Therefore, 5x minus 4y equal 20. Now also, if we use right-hand side of the equation, we get 4x equal 25 minus 5y, right? Therefore, 4x plus 5y equal 25. Okay, our goal is to find x, right? So I want to eliminate y. To do this, I multiply the first equation by 5 and the second equation by 4. Then add them together. If you notice that, these are again, so 25x plus 16x equal 100 plus 100, right? Therefore, 41x equal 200. So x is going to be 200 over 41. Okay, this was the first method. Now we will calculate value of x using second method. We know that here is 90 degrees because of tangent, and if we can make point O and point B like this, we get an angle bisector line, right? Why? Notice that if we draw a perpendicular line like this, this length is also radius, right? So if we focus on this quadrilateral is a kite, right? So let's call these two equal angles alpha. If you focus on triangle ADB, for this triangle, if we calculate sine 2 alpha, sine 2 alpha equal x over 5, right? You know that sine 2 alpha, the expansion of sine 2 alpha equal 2 times sine alpha times cosine alpha equal x over 5. Therefore, if you focus on this triangle, let's call hypotenuse as y. Then, if we apply Pythagorean theorem for this triangle, we get 4 squared plus 5 squared equal y squared. Therefore, 16 plus 25 equal y squared. So, y is going to be root 41. Let's write here, y equal root 41. Now we can calculate sine alpha easily, right? Sine alpha equal 4 over root 41 times cosine alpha equal 5 over root 41 equal x over 5. So 40 over 41 equal x over 5. That means x is going to be 200 over 41. Thanks for watching. If you want more videos like this, please don't forget to like and subscribe my channel. Take care and bye bye.